Shall we begin? Okay, so this video is long overdue because I ended the challenge ages ago. But it's basically the advice that I would give to somebody, to everybody who's going on the challenge. And a bit about my time on the challenge. If you didn't know, I went on the challenge this summer. I think I was on the second wave, so I was one of the very first to like get out into the field, and I'm actually really glad that I did that. If you want to know more about what it was like for me, you can go check out my vlogs. Yeah, that's pretty straightforward. I live in Manchester, but I went with the Rochdale group, and I don't really know why I did that, but I did it, and so I knew like nobody, and it was everybody was from these schools I've never heard of, but I'm really glad that I did it in the end. Yeah, let's begin. Number one is to buy good bug spray or insect repellent, as people call it. So if you're going camping, I personally think this is really, really crucial, because if you don't, then you might be faced with the biggest challenge of your life, which is living with all these bugs for a week, which is what happened to me. So when I got there, I was in for a big surprise because there's all these bugs and I don't really like bugs that much. And it was just so horrible because by the time I got home that week, I was covered in bites, and it was just so... Definitely research the place where you're going to, find out what bugs are indigenous to that area, and then buy bug spray to combat that just in case, and cream for after you get bitten. Yeah, I mean, it might not apply to everybody, but it's worth the risk of taking bug spray just in case. My second tip would be to prepare for anything. And by anything, I mean like literally anything. And I'm mainly applying this to camping because I don't think I was prepared for camping mentally and physically as I should have been. And that's not like the fault of the people, because they do give you everything if you don't bring them or have them. But I really wish that I would have brought more dry clothes. And I think dry clothes is really universal. Whatever happens, dry clothes are really, really useful. For the first week, I definitely suggest overpacking. Now, I don't mean to like bring your whole wardrobe, but definitely pack maybe more than you might expect, because it gives you a bit of choice. And I did this a little bit, but I knew people who did this a lot. You don't know what activities you might be doing as well, because you're away for the whole week. There's no going back home to change. This one is pretty simple. Don't complain. I knew so many people who went on the challenge who complained about everything. And I just thought it was absolutely ridiculous, because the reason why you're going on the challenge, or hopefully the reason why, is to have a bit of fun and just to kind of relax over the summer and make it count. So don't complain, please don't, because it ruins everybody else's fun as well as yours, and it just kind of sucks out the fun out of it. So just don't complain, go with the flow, and things might not be amazing. Okay, so bringing a comfort thing. Now, if you're one of those people who gets really homesick, or even just a tad bit, you want to go home, I would definitely bring a bit of something that would make you feel better in the worst case scenario. Chances are you're not gonna feel like this. Bring like chocolate, or your favorite book, or your favorite music. A major tip of mine is to walk away from drama. You'll just end up making enemies and losing new friends when you just should be enjoying yourself. So walk away from drama. That's what I did, and I'm really glad that I did it. I just try to talk to everybody and make friends with everybody. You're just with these people for 3 weeks, and I saw some girls talk about other girls who they've never known. This next one is really crucial if you really want to have a good time on the challenge. And I say that being open-minded and just ready to experience new things is really, really, really important. Definitely be ready to make new friends and experience new things, and kind of let go of fears and challenges that you might face, if you know what I mean. And just kind of be ready to challenge yourself and make new friends and do things that you would otherwise be absolutely terrified to do. I'm glad I did it because I just thought to myself, put one leg in front of the other and challenge yourself and just try your best and you will get the full 100% out of it. So don't hesitate, don't let anything stop you, don't let any fear stop you, and just go for it. So I don't know, I hope this is helpful.